Hello students, we were discussing about linear inequalities graphically. So question number 1e part that I gave you homework was y is greater than 2x plus 1. You have to draw its graph. Firstly, I told you you have to convert the inequality into equality. So the sign of inequality will be replaced by equal to sign. Y is equal to 2x plus 1. Now we will draw this line on the graph. We need two coordinates to draw the graph. So put x is equal to 0 in this equation, so y will be equal to 1. Similarly, if I put y is equal to 0, then x will be minus 1 by 2. So my two coordinates are 0, 1 and minus 1 by 2, 0. So these two are the coordinates. Join them indefinitely, so we will get the line. Now here, we don't have the equality sign. It is a strict inequality, so it will be a dotted line. So let us draw it again. It will be a dotted line like this. Right, now I need to know which region I have to shade. So we will shade the region that contains the solutions. How to decide? This is region 1 to the right hand side of the line, and to the left hand side of the line is region 2. So let us take one coordinate. I told you better to take origin because it is easy to make calculations with origin. So let us take this origin. Substitute in the given inequality, 0 is greater than 1. Which is not true, 0 is never greater than 1. Not true, it means the region that contains origin will not be shaded, it will not contain the solution. So the other region will contain the solution, I will shade that region. So solution lies in the region that do not contain origin because it is a false inequality. Next, graphing more than one inequality. This is exercise 14.3 from your book. How to graph more than one inequality? Suppose we have three inequalities, y is less than equal to x, y is greater than 1 and x is less than equal to 5. Firstly, I will replace the inequality sign with equality sign. It will be y is equal to x, y is equal to 1 and x is equal to 5. I have to draw all the three graphs. So firstly, for this, when x is equal to 0, then y will also be equal to 0. When x is equal to 1, then y will also be equal to 1. So my two coordinates are 0, 0 and 1, 1. So this is 0, 0 and this is 1, 1. Now draw the line. This will be line y is equal to x. This is the line y is equal to x. Next is y is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1 is the line like this, a horizontal line. Now clearly, we don't have equality sign, so it will be a dotted line. Here we were having an equality sign, so it was a solid line. Next, x is less than equal to 5. So x is equal to 5 means this line. We have equality here also, so it will be a solid line. So let us draw the graphs again. This is the line, y is equal to x. Next was the line, y is greater than 1. So it was a dotted line, so it will be like this. Right? After that, the line was x is equals to 5. It will be here. It will be a solid line because equality sign is also there. See, this line is intersecting here. This line is intersecting here. Right, and this is the origin. So this is the coordinate 5, 0. This is the coordinate 5, 1, 5, 5. And this is 0, 0. And this is 0, 1. Right? Now in the question, it is told that you have to shade the region that contains the common solution. So common solution means which satisfy all the three lines. We will not shade that region that contains the simultaneous solution. So we will leave that region in which the solution for all the three equations will lie. So let us start. For the line y is less than equal to x, right? Let us take some coordinate. Let it be 2, 2. Or let us take the another coordinate. For example, this is the line y is equal to x. Let me take the coordinate from this region. So let me take this 2, 0. Now substitute in the inequality. X 0, y 2. Sorry, x 2, y 0. 0 is less than equal to 2. Is it true? Yes, it is true. It means this region contains my solution. I have to shade the region which do not contain the solution. So I will shade this region which do not contain solution. It is written in the question. Next is y is greater than 1. Now y is greater than 1. This is y is equal to 1. Y greater than 1 means the upper region. So I will shade the region that do not contain, right? After that, I have to shade x is less than equal to 5. Now this is x is equal to 5. X less than equal to 5 means to the left. So I will shade this region which do not contain solution. So what is the common region that I don't shade is this triangle. I have shaded this. I have shaded this. I have shaded this downward. So this is left. So it means this triangle is feasible region. Now your homework is to complete all the other questions of this exercise. I hope you understand now. Thank you. Have a nice day.